Abang ada ah?
Yes.
Abang ada. Abang ada, what you doing?
Yes. Yes.
Abang ada. Can you stop playing games? We need to go to school.
Eh? Huh?
Abang ada, get on the bus now.
Hey.
Abang ada, it's late. We need to go to school. Can you stop playing with your phone and your game?
Hey.
I am going to tell my mommy and daddy.
Our story began clear, very story, as double to our people and vision. We stand together, urging our dreams together. Hey, boss, we are with the same. We are the heroes, school bus heroes. We are school bus heroes.
I want to go to school, but Abang Ado just wouldn't stop playing with his phone. He and his video games.
Yeah. You want to play?
No.
Why?
I want to go to school. It's so late. Look at the time.
I don't care. You know, games can give you many benefits. You can make money of it.
Oh, really? And how is that?
I show you. I bring you to see someone.
Really?
You, yeah, very professional
really?
Gamer. Yeah, really.
Okay. Hey guys, my name is Jesus Faya.
And I'm your bus driver, Abang Adwa.
And you're watching
School Bus Hero.
Today's episode of
School Bus Heroes!
With me, your host, Jesper Supaya.
And your bus driver, Abang Adwa.
We have a very, very special hero with us today. We have Abang Hakim!
Yay!
Hi, Abang Hakim! Thank you so much for joining us on our school bus today. Maybe you can tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, so my name is Abdul Hakim Tajuddin. I'm also known as Ranger. I'm the captain of Rampage Gaming,
wow.
The professional Call of Duty team in Malaysia. And I'm also working as an intern in IXC Sports.
Wow. So what do you actually do? What is esports all about?
Okay, so esports is basically called electronic sports. So it's a new industry in the world right now. It's been going on like a trend. So esports basically not just you playing video games. A lot of things going on in esports. You can be like a videographer, you can be like a graphic designer, anything. Everything is one package, one esports. But the most famous one is gamers. Like, you can make money share from esports. Esports is such a good entertainment for people, youngsters right now, and such a healthy industry in my opinion. And what I do now is I'm a part-time professional gamer and in Rampage Gaming, and I'm also a full-time worker in IXC Sports as a graphic designer.
Wow, graphic designer, Abang
yes.
Adwa.
Yes.
That is so cool. So maybe Abang, you can tell us a little bit about your school times, your childhood memories, or whatever that influenced you in order for you to be what you are today.
Okay, so my primary school wasn't that much of a happening, in my opinion, because I was kind of an introvert back then, really introvert back then. I wasn't really talking much to people, I didn't have much friends back then. But when I stepped into high school, I started to make a lot of friends because I told myself that this is a new life for me. I had to start new and start fresh. And then starting from there, I started to see the other side of myself. I see that I'm more of a vocal type of person, I'm more of a leadership type of person. And other than that, my high school is just awesome. Other than if compared to my primary school. So my high school did not actually influence me at all. It was actually from myself. I actually found gaming as such a good. I mean, it was actually a hobby. I started playing video games when I was 4 years old. It was my sister that introduced to me, and then it was. I could still remember that time when I wanted to play the PlayStation 1. It was Harvest Moon. It was my sister's favorite video games. And she gave me the controller, but it wasn't plugged in.
Okay.
She actually tricked me. She thought, because she wanted me to play the game. So I had to I thought I was playing the video game.
Uh-huh.
Starting from there, I started to play on my own. And then I started to love game more when I was 12 years old. Mm. And then after that, it started to, when I got my PS3 after my UPSR, mm. and my dad bought it to me. And then when I was 15, I was introduced to competitive gaming in Calgary. And that's how I got the love of competing in this game.
In Calgary.
So quality has been a great, influence to myself because that game is such a great game. Mm-hmm. I've been watching a lot of professional players playing the video games because at that moment I had a few friends tell me that, hey, why don't you try to go professional in this profession? Because mm-hmm. I see you have a big talent, you have a potential of becoming a very good player in the future. So I took their words and then here I am today.
Abang Hakim, do you have any advices for those young kids out there who are actually studying but yet very, very addicted to video games sometimes until they don't even focus on your education? How do you advise them on that?
Okay, so I've been to those shows before when I was a young kid. I mean, all gamers back then were addicted to video games. Yeah. But education is always your priority and that you can never neglect in your life. So my advice is that you need to force yourself to have a schedule. Like, you can play video games anytime you want, but make sure you don't get a bad grade in your school. And then make sure that all your homeworks are done. But most importantly, you need to balance your time between video games and also your education. Because whatever it is, education is your backup plan.
Yeah.
If it doesn't work, I mean, you always have to go back to education because that's the thing that's going to give you, going to pay the bills for your future and all that stuff. So I think kids nowadays need to understand how to balance time more. It's just time management basically. It's not even just video games, because I see a lot of people getting addicted to some other things like, you know, going out with friends, hanging out, all that stuff. It's just how you know how to manage your time. If you know how to manage your time on both things that you love, and it'll be great. It'll be fine to your parents and also to yourself. So to be a professional gamer, you need to have a very strong mindset, telling yourself every day that you're gonna get better and you're gonna win something. Because nowadays, what I see in our community, in our people that try to pursue professional in this game, they quit midways. I mean, they have talent, they have potential, but eventually, along the ways, when they are progressing to their goals, they just be like, hey, I'm gonna stop. I don't think I have a future in this. That's the wrong thing that most people do nowadays in esports. Like, it's the same thing as anything. You want to achieve something in life, you need to set your goals high, and then you're gonna go and get it. No matter how hard it gets, you just have to go and get it.
Abang, maybe we can see you in action.
Hopefully one day.
Yeah, we can see you play.
2 more weeks.
So where are you bringing us today?
Okay, so I'm gonna bring you to the training center.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So we're going to the training center now.
Can't wait. Let's go.
Let's go.
Fun.
I mean, it's really fun if you ask me. Like, you go to work, but actually we're not just, I mean, they are all gamers here, but they also do a lot of things. Like the one you see on the other side of the room is, we have Azami here, actually our videographer, and then you have Izati at the back, she's our production manager, and then we have Sakaichi Aiman, he's actually our host and commentator.
So what did you do actually?
Okay, so over here, XeSports. What we do is we are a esports company, so we provide tournaments, we make tournaments, and then we provide a lot of things such as production-wise. Let's say you want an event, then we are the one that you can call and where's the event for you. So these are all the workers that are working here. So yeah, esports is not just playing video games. Like, these guys, they are really good at video games, and they are also good at soft skills. It's actually, esports develop a lot of talents, and you also have soft skills. So not this kind of gamers is what we want. This kind of gamers are actually productive and also good for the country and individuals.
How many hours do they actually sit here every day?
Oh, actually office hours. We come here at 9 and we go back at 5:30.
So I've heard you have won recently.
Oh yeah.
So
yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, this one. Is the.
So can you do?
Okay. So this is the. You can hold it, you want. So it's like
champion.
So this is called the Asia Championship. It's an annual event. It's been going on for 4 years
straight. International, right?
Yeah.
International.
It's international event. It was in Hong Kong back then, and that's my second major championship back to back. I won first one last year, and then I won it again this year.
Wow.
So it was a privilege for me to have the second trophy. My first trophy was at my home. So.
Thank you for bringing Asia.
Asia Championship champion.
I first get to know Hakim when it was the Asia Championships, Call of Duty Asia Championships last year in Kuala Lumpur. I was one of the interviewers, so I get to meet him and also all his teammates and all the other Call of Duty community. And what I see from him is he's very, very passionate in what he's doing, and that is why he is one of the best in Asia right now. Although he has work, although he's studying, he always put the game in front as well as his main priority. He learns about the game. He is like the definition of a student in the game, so that is why I think they will do very, very well in the future tournaments, which is CWL London, Anaheim, and I hope that they can go all the way to the Call of Duty World Championships and then to what they say is the heaven, the real dream of every professional COD players, which is the CWL Pro League. I really, really wish that they will do it, especially for Hakim. He is very, very passionate. I would love to see him there in the future.
Wow. Oh. You see, fast, you know?
So fast. Oh,
wow.
Oh, okay. Man down.
So I want to ask you, why your team name Rampage?
Okay, so I got the name Rampage Gaming. It actually took me a week to name my team, because my old team name was Evolution Gaming, then I wanted to change the name to Rampage because I okay, yes, it suits my playstyle. Like when I built this team, my teammate was a bunch of people that just like to rush things out, like how I'm playing right now. Because when we see an enemy, we just go to them.
It's moving so fast.
So actually, Rampage is just like a, you know, like a bull just charge everything they see. So yeah, that's why I like the name, and it really resembles how I play the game. Yeah, so that's
man
how
down,
I
man down.
Yes, it.
Yeah, so that's how I got the name Rampage.
So how do you actually get income from playing games like that?
Okay, so most of the time, like back then and also now, I get my income mostly from tournament winning. So yeah, so that's like that's how most people, gamers get their income, like from winning tournaments and stuff. So actually, we got a lot from it. Like recently, when I won the Asia Championship in Hong Kong, I got like 12k USD.
Wow.
Yeah, as a team. So let's say you actually make money in like one day. I actually play for one day and then I got 12k. If you think about it, it's actually insane.
It's a USD, right?
Yeah.
USD.
I have a question. Like this game, right?
Yeah.
You shoot people, kill people. Yeah. This thing can influence our mind, you know the case, right?
Okay.
Ah, yeah.
Honestly, it's a virtual thing. And then it all comes down to yourself, like how you portray this thing. Yes. If you're really addicted to the game, that's when you get all the negativity in your brain. Like, I can kill people in game, I can kill people like in real life. Actually, wrong. Yeah, but honestly, I'm telling you, I'm playing video first person shooting this FPS game, shooting people every day. I don't feel like shooting anyone in my life.
Yeah.
Never in my life I wanted to shoot. I'm a shooter in real life. I mean, I used to represent my school in the shooting competition. Yeah, that was actually fun. But I never had the gut to shoot because it's just wrong.
Yeah.
Because
wrong.
And everything is comes down to yourself and your brain. You have to think about it. Like if you shoot people, that's a criminal. That's already a bad thing, and also gonna give a bad influence. So yeah, it all comes down to yourself and how you know. And you can do anything in life, and that thing can turn out to be a bad thing. But it all comes down to yourself. How you, how you like portray it to yourself. How do you understand it? And how do you show it to the people around your community?
So, Abang Hakim, apart from your work, which is playing games, what do you do for a hobby?
Yeah, what is your hobby?
So, I really like fitness in general because my dad is a triathlete. He does triathlon. Back then, I was supposed to be a triathlete like him, but then I got stuck with the video games. So, I just follow. I mean,
did they support you?
It was hard time trying to convince him.
Like, but now you changed.
But now,
His mind, right?
Yes, because I won that. I got second place. I got 2,000 ringgit, and he fetched me at the bus station in Lakin, and he was like, "Do you really win money in this one?" Like, now do you trust me? And then he like, started from there. He started to support me and started to give me encouragement and all stuff.
So, when coming back to your hobby,
you
have to show us your moves, your skills. Okay. Red, you mentioned in the gym, right?
Yeah, in the gym, yeah.
That's, so, can you show us?
Can you show us? Let's go.
Yeah.
What? Yeah.
Hey. Hey.
What happened? What? Your face become like that?
I'm a gamer. Don't disturb me. You know I'm a gamer. This is international.
You are not a gamer. I am the gamer.
No. I?
You are just a bus driver. I am the one that makes money playing games.
I've already sent the kids. I send you home. Later I tell your parents, okay?
No, you don't have
you
to.
You play game. You cannot because.
Don't tell my parents because I earn money from this.
Hey, you earn money. Hey, I'm a gamer. I'm international. So, okay, you want to play? You play.
Hey guys! So we're with Tian En today. Hi! How are you feeling?
Good.
You're feeling good because you just finished your practice? So can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yeah.
I'm 8 years old.
Okay.
And I've been doing gymnastics for 2 years.
You're 8 and you've been doing gymnastics for 2 years. Yeah. Wow. And what have you learned in these 2 years?
I learned how to use clap.
So what was your favorite apparatus?
Yes.
Clap.
And your favorite element?
Side ballet.
So you were doing something just now. Can you show us what was that? Yes.
So,
wow. So what pose do you call this?
Side balance.
So, how you can do that?
First we do split, then after that we stand up and then we lift up our leg.
Oh, so you have to learn to split first. If you cannot split, you cannot do that. So Tianen, what did you win for Queen's Cup?
Medals. I won 3rd place for ribbon.
Wow.
And
ribbon?
Rope.
Wow, that's so cool. Do you want back your what do you call this?
Clap.
So how do you use this again? You want to show us one more time? Wow, okay. Tianen, so do you have anything you want to share to your friends out there who are actually watching you right now?
I want to be in the Olympics.
Wow, she wants to be in the
you
Olympics.
You will.
You have probably heard it. Sitting all day behind a desk is bad for your health. The more stationary you are, the higher the risk of your obesity-related disease, such as diabetes. This applies to the professional gamer like Abang Hakim. He's lucky that he's always lived a healthy lifestyle since school days. And for the rest of us, with busy working life, going to school, and other responsibilities that cut away our free time, please try to remember to give your body a little extra bit of time and tender loving care. Set small goals, recruit a workout buddy to see through, and before you know it, you'll be on the right track to live a healthy lifestyle.
So Abang, how often do you actually come here?
Okay, so going to the gym, I usually go here like 5 times a week. And...
Are you okay? What did you do?
100 kilo! Come on!
Wow!
That was just 10!
Why gym? Why?
So, gym is basically, I've been doing gym for like almost 2 years now, but I've been slacking off lately because I was busy with works. But fitness has always been my go-to besides gaming because back then I like to, you know, do fitness in school. I was an athletic, I joined the athletic group in back in high school. And besides that, it also gives really stress, you know, when I play video games. I mean, I get stressed a lot, so this is kind of like one of the good place for me to, you know, release it out. You know, and
so is it increase your strength to play the controller?
Okay, technically.
Show the other contestant. I have big hand, no?
I don't know. Big hand doesn't help much, it does help you mentally. Like, your mind is always clear and, like, you're always, like, prepared to, you know, like, you're
is
training
always
your
go for it and go for it.
Yep.
until the very end, you just don't give up.
Yep. So basically, when I go here, I just release all my, like I said, my stressfulness. My if I get mad at someone, just go here, just release it up.
So how does gym
motivate you?
Yeah. How does it motivate you?
I like to watch like motivational videos, and most of it they are always on gym. So all these people that are working out in the gym, they always there are people that always motivated. There are people that always gives you motivation. So every time when I watch them, I feel like what they're doing right now is basically just so inspiring. So when I come here, I feel like I have to train myself to be a better person. Also, this is healthy. Yeah. So when you come, when you play video games and then you have a healthy life,
it's I'm sweating a lot.
Yeah. Me too now, not anything. Yeah. So yeah, when you come here and then you sweat and then, I mean, you don't have to come gym like seven times in a week. You can come here like 1 to 2 days just to, you know, get some sweat out of your body. Yeah, it's fine. And make sure that you're healthy.
So do you, how heavy do you lift?
The heaviest I ever lift in my life was my bench press was 90 kg.
90?
Yeah. That was the highest mark I ever gotten.
So you're gonna lift some weights for us to show us what you lift?
Probably not 90 kg now, because I just ate lunch. But yeah, some 10 or 20 kilos will be fine. Yeah.
10?
Yes. So let's go.
Lift it.
Yep.
Let's lift it.
Yep.
So you just CC lah.
I can lift too.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's the end already.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. We have learned a lot. So any motivational quotes that you can share with us?
Okay. So the only quotes that I've been holding with myself until now is if you want success, you have to get it yourself. No one else is going to push you to the limit. So if you want success, go get it yourself. Period.
Go get it yourself, guys. All right, guys. Thank you so much for watching us today.